Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Brereus Kerensky here for another completely out of the blue video. This is Labirynth no Kanata, a rather old game. It came out in 2012, sorry. It's done by Triace, best known for Star Ocean and Valkyrie Profile. I'm recording this video because I've changed computer and I've also changed some of my editing programs, updated them, and this is a test run to see that everything works well. And I've chosen this game for, well, I had it sitting in my library for quite some time. I bought these used, so there might be, yeah, there is a save file. Let's override this. Yeah. So let's start our adventure. When the game has finished creating the save file, and it did. The T-pad moves the map around, and the discover the party member. Okay, I need to get left and right on the analog knob, rotate the point of view, and L and R. No, sorry. Left and right on the analog knob strafe. Oh, sorry. And this is getting me confused a lot. Oh, encounter. Left and right on the D-pad, choose your attack, I guess. That also increases or decreases the time you wait between attacks, I guess. And okay. B and X rotate your point of view vertically. To be honest, I'm kind of surprised that the game starts like this. Because on the back of the game case there is something that looked more like a 3D action game. Thank you. party, remember? And R are switched to what I'm used to move around. Okay, fourth party member. Hello, Lily. Beside me, you are the only name I can read. Okay. Ah, okay, there is a element triangle. Okay. The only thing is that how do I change targets? Ah, okay. You have to press Y and the D-pad. So red is strong against green. Okay, you also have that on above the enemy's health bar. Nice. Alright. Everyone is skipping. Is okay. So they are talking to me, but I don't really understand what they're saying. Okay, that thing that looks like a dinosaur or something. Thank you. Okay, that was the same thing as the red enemies before. As the red enemies before, just. Recolored. I don't know what the numbers on the top right corner mean. No. But I started to get in the hang of the battle system. Okay, you can also change your target with the touchscreen. Attack on the red warrior, won't call it skeleton. Again, oh, oh. Keeps telling me to press start to save things, but things look scary. Let's kill this red thing first. Did the blue thing just heal itself? Okay, dead end. Okay, this is dead. This Itrian Odyssey is not, but I'm kinda curious to see. Okay, that's fine. Okay, I guess this is the right path, but to conclude my sentence earlier, I'm kinda curious to see if and when this turns out to be the action 3D game that it was that's advertised on the game case. Okay, let's choose the second option just for giggles. If anything, right now this game reminds me of the Darkspire, at least due to his art style, or better, how the whole game moves. Darkspire was even more minimalist. Yeah, I think this is the correct accent. Then Labirynth no Kanata. Okay. I'm taking a look at every dead end because I hope to see something different than torches on the wall. No such luck, only torches, torches, and more torches on the walls. Yes, I'm here. Okay. Oh, this is kinda clever. I will be speaking in the microphone. Can you hear me? Bah.
もしかしてこの窓の向こうって別の世界なの？
Maybe this is not a 3D action game, but... Oh. Okay, instead of turning 90 degrees, now you turn 45. Girl, where are you?
あれ？さっきは気づかなかったけど、何か書いてある。何何？
I'm skipping the explanation. Yeah, I get statics whenever she is near your camera, I guess.
Notta? Kore, ue ya shita ni ittari suru karakuri na no.
Did our chain completely change color
with
the... They were much more blue before. Well, yeah, I guess it was the environmental light to make her hair look so blue. Yeah, the movement isn't smooth, even if you can... well, you can move relatively smooth. Okay, healing point. Hope it works also as a save.
さすがにね、もうダメだって思ったんだ。 下も見えないような高さから落ちたんだもの。でも、ちょうどあそこに落ちて助かったみたい。 ああ、変な通せん棒はこの先だよ。
Okay, this also works as a save point. Well, I guess I was completely wrong about the game's style. This is a dungeon crawler, alright. Okay, this is... Oh, nice, this... Okay, I got 35 exp, and it's shared between everyone. I need 10 points to upgrade life, and 500 points, that's a lot, to increase strength. I'll wait for those 500 points.
ここがね、通れないんだよ。向こうに道が見えるんだけどね。
She probably didn't realize about the tattoo on her back and the symbol on that force field that were the same, but yeah, I guess this is to be expected. Let's go! See things in the background. Okay, you can save here. Or movement isn't great because you can move your viewpoint 45 degrees, but movement is only at 90 degrees angles. So it's a weird mix. It is smoother than, let's say, Etrian Odyssey, where you could only move 90 degrees, but I think it's best to either have one of the two systems completely movement-free or... Yeah, don't run toward the monster, girl. Yeah. Is she attacking me? Okay. And suddenly monster attacks... deal much more damage. She does something? I see. Yeah. I don't think it did anything. Okay, everyone here is a mage. So, a lot of attention has gone into the girl. Let's see. Let's try to peek down this hole. You really can't peek down this hole, and I won't take the step forward to see if I can. Thank you. What exactly that did, I don't really know. Let's see how the battle really work. So, I think that the numbers on the top right also are used to heal your character when they attack. Let's see, 1000, 1000. Yeah. So you essentially you have to fight to heal your character, because here you have items, I guess. This is the battle turns, those are the dialogues, and this is the map. You don't have... any real menu. You can move at 45 degrees. Degrees, not degrees. Yeah, my character has been healed. It's a bit strange, the system, but... for the girl, pick up a rock and throw it to the monster that's completely out of sight. That's clever, girl, completely clever. I wonder if I can skip turns. But I guess that's what less powerful attacks are for. Well, I guess that even if the monster was completely away from our party, it was fair game. You move the camera and you also select the target by doing that. And the game automatically targets something for you. Okay. Okay, the girl can be attacked too, but I don't see her HP anywhere. Okay, this is an alien spot. Yeah, the fact that you can rotate the camera while moving and you move in the direction you input before is very strange. Okay, now she knows that she can open doors, or better, force fields. Direct the girl to what will attack. You can actually change targets while others are taking their turn. Her health is on the lower upper left. I must be completely blind. Yeah, this is a game that must be played with the lower screen visible. No one is pointing out that thing on the ground, whatever. Okay, wrong path. We'll have to backtrack, but at least compared to also Etrian Odyssey and well, a lot of other dungeon crawlers here, you see the enemy, so you kinda know what you will be up against, which is always nice. No, you can't really direct the girl. Yeah, it's weird that the screen shows statics when she passes near your camera. Not the best effect. I really wish I could understand what they're saying. Let's go against these enemies now that I am almost full health. It's strange that you can actually move around while engaged in battle, while you can't. How did I do that before? I think that when she attacks, you can press the A button to improve her attack. My completely randomized guess. Yeah, I don't really need to heal, but Monsters actually move around the labyrinth, that's a nice thing. I wish I could move around because... targeted, yeah. Those black spots are their corpses. And I wish I could move around because really I don't know what I'm... okay. So the hour for this first hour play is almost up. I will complete this floor though. Correctly, now that thing shouldn't heal because there is only green magic available. So want my character also because she is at top form. But now my character, yeah, healed by 110, and then she will heal by 230, but. Not really, because she's at full health. A door! Try to press Y. So this is... okay, thank you. I wish movement was a bit faster. Something that has to be much, much clearer in this game is what enemies are active and what not, and which not. Because I never thought these two would be active in the same battle with the blue blob before. That way. Yeah, I'm wondering that myself. I think this allows to change your character's elemental affinity, if you will. Now let's backtrack to the door then. I wish, really wish that movement was faster. Thank you. Okay, you can initiate battle by pressing A while you're close to enemies. And I wish I could escape this battle. Let's see how much damage this thing does. Okay, maybe I should be able to. I really wish I could skip a turn, because I want my other warrior to heal, but I can't seem to do that, unfortunately. It will have been only 70 points, but better than nothing, since on two attacks went against the second red guy. This will take a while. My guys is dead. Oh yeah, I can escape easily. Okay. Escape party annihilation, or I think, but the thing is, I don't know how to heal my guy. Thank you. Okay, she can pick up items. And since we have reached the door to the next level, I will end this video here. I hope you have enjoyed this first hour play completely out of nowhere, and I hope that the post-production will go alright. So, see you next time. Briareus Kerensky, over and out.